Hello all. Today we're going to learn about privately held American clothing company Levi's. Most of us have already heard about this company. Let us know this company in a much better way. Levi's Strauss Incorporation is a privately held American clothing company known worldwide for its Levi's brand of denim jeans. It was founded in 1853 when Levi Strauss came from Buttenheim, Bavaria to San Francisco, California to open a West Coast branch of his brother's New York dry goods business. The company's corporate headquarters is located at Levi's Plaza in San Francisco. Levi Strauss & Corporation is a worldwide corporation organized into three geographic divisions. Levi Strauss America LSA, based in the San Francisco headquarters, Levi Strauss Europe, Middle East and Africa, LSEMA, based in Brussels and Asia Pacific Division, APD, based in Singapore. The company employs a staff of approximately 10,500 people worldwide. Levi Strauss started the business at the 90 Sacramento Street address in San Francisco. He next moved the location to 62 Sacramento Street, then 63 and 65 Sacramento Street. Jacob Davis, a Latvian Jewish immigrant, was a Reno, Nevada tailor who frequently purchased bolts of cloth made from denim from Levi Strauss Incorporation's wholesale house. After one of Davis's customers kept purchasing cloth to reinforce torn pants, he had an idea to use copper rivets to reinforce the points of strain, such as on the pocket corners and at the base of the button fly. Davis did not have the required money to purchase a patent, so he wrote to Strauss suggesting that they go into business together. After Levi accepted Jacob's offer on May 20, 1873, the two men received U.S. patent 139,121 from the United States Patent and Trademark Office. The patented rivet was later incorporated into the company's jean design and advertisements. Contrary to an advertising campaign suggesting that Levi Strauss sold his first jeans to gold miners during the California Gold Rush, which peaked in 1849, the manufacturing of denim overalls only began in the 1870s. The company created the first pair of Levi's 501 jeans in the 1890s, a style that went on to become the world's best-selling item of clothing. Between the 1950s and 1980s, Levi's jeans became popular among a wide range of youth subcultures, including greasers, mod, rockers, and hippies. Levi's popular shrink-to-fit 501s was sold in a unique sizing arrangement. The indicated size referred to the size of the jeans prior to shrinking, and the shrinkage was substantial. The company still produces these unshrunk, uniquely sized jeans, and they are still Levi's number one selling product. Although popular lore abetted by company marketing holds that the original design remains unaltered, this is not the case. The crotch rivet and waist cinch was removed during World War II to conform to war production board requirements to conserve metal and was not replaced after the war. Additionally, the back pocket rivets, which had been covered in denim since 1937, were removed completely in the 1950s due to complaints they scratched furniture. From a company with 15 sales people, two plants and almost no business east of the Mississippi in 1946, the organization grew in 30 years to include a sales force of more than 22,000 with 50 plants and offices in 35 countries. From the early 1960s through the mid-1970s, Levi Strauss experienced significant growth in its business as the more casual look of the 1960s and 1970s ushered in the blue jeans craze and served as a catalyst for the brand. Levi's, under the leadership of Walter Haas, Peter Haas Sr., Paul Glasgow and George P. Simpkins Sr., expanded the firm's clothing line by adding new fashions and models, including stoned wash jeans, through the acquisition of Great Western Garment Corporation, GWG, a Canadian clothing manufacturer acquired by Levi's. The Dockers brand, launched in 1986, which is sold largely through department store chains, helped the company grow through the mid-1990s as denim sales began to fade. Dockers were introduced into Europe in 1996. Levi Strauss attempted to sell the Dockers division in 2004 to relieve part of the company's $2.6 billion outstanding debt. By the 1990s, the brand was facing competition from other brands and cheaper products from overseas and began accelerating the pace of its U.S. factory closures and its use of offshore subcontracting agreements. In 1991, Levi Strauss faced a scandal involving pants made in the Northern Mariana Islands, where some 3% of Levi's jeans sold annually with the Made in the USA label were shown to have been made by Chinese laborers under what the United States Department of Labor called slave-like conditions. Today, most Levi's jeans are made outside the US, though a few of the higher-end, more expensive styles are still made in the US. The company took on multi-billion dollar debt in February 1996 to help finance a series of leveraged stock buyouts among family members. Shares in Levi's Strauss stock are not publicly traded. The firm is today owned almost entirely by indirect descendants and collateral relatives of Levi's Strauss, whose four nephews inherited the San Francisco dry goods firm after their uncle's death in 1902. The corporation's bonds are traded publicly and are shares of the company's Japanese affiliate, Levi's Strauss Japan KK. In June 1996, the company offered to pay its workers an unusual dividend of up to $750 million in 6 years' time, having halted an employee stock plan at the time of the internal family buyout. However, the company failed to make cash flow targets and no worker dividends were paid. In 2002, Levi Strauss began close business collaboration with Walmart, producing a special line of signature jeans and other clothes for exclusive sale in Walmart stores until 2006. Levi Strauss signature jeans can now be purchased at several stores in the US, Canada, Australia, New Zealand, India, Pakistan, and Japan. According to the New York Times, Levi Strauss leads the apparel industry in trademark infringement cases, filing nearly 100 lawsuits against competitors since 2001. Most cases center on the alleged imitation of Levi's back pocket double a stitching pattern, U.S. trademark number 1,139,254, which Levi filed for trademark in 1978. Levi's has successfully sued Guess, Polo, Ralph Lauren, Esprit Holdings, Zegna, Zumeis, and Lucky Brand Jeans, among other companies. In 2002, the company closed its Valencia Street plant in San Francisco, which had opened the same year of the city's April 1906 earthquake. By the end of 2003, the closure of Levi's last U.S. factory in San Antonio ended 150 years of his jeans being made in the USA. By 2007, Levi Strauss was again said to be profitable after declining sales in 9 of the previous 10 years. Its total annual sales of just over $4 billion were $3 billion less than during its peak performance in the mid-1990s. After more than 2 decades of family ownership, rumors of a possible public stock offering were floated in the media in July 2007. In 2009, it was noted in the media for selling jeans on interest-free credit due to the global recession. In 2010, the company partnered with Filson, an outdoor goods manufacturer in Seattle, to produce a high-end line of jackets and workwear. On May 8, 2013, the NFL's San Francisco 49ers announced that Levi Strauss Incorporation had purchased the naming rights to their new stadium in Santa Clara, California. The naming rights deal calls for Levi's to pay $220.3 million to the city of Santa Clara and the 49ers over 20 years, with an option to extend the deal for another 5 years for around $75 million. Levi's marketing has often made use of old recordings of popular music in television commercials, ranging from traditional pop to punk rock. Notable examples include Ben E. King's Stand By Me, Percy Sledge, When a Man Loves a Woman, Eddie Cochran, Come On Everybody, Mark Bolan, 20th Century Boy, Screaming Jay Hawkins' Heart Attack and Vine, The Clash, Should I Stay or Should I Go, as well as lesser-known materials such as Falling Elevators and The City Sleeps by Mech 900, featuring Jesus and Flat Beat, and Monday Massacre by Mr. Ozio. Many of these songs were re-released by the record labels as a tie-in with the ad campaigns, resulting in increased popularity and sales of the recordings and the creation of iconic visual associations with the music, such as the use of a topless male model wearing jeans underwater in the 1986 adverts featuring Wonderful World and Mad About the Boy and the puppet Flat Eric in the ads featuring music by Mr. Ozio. So we got to know about the various aspects of Levi's. We went through the company's history to its present-day scenario. Hope the information was useful and have a good day.